Woolly mammoths appeared about 2.6 million years ago and lived in the northern regions of Europe, Asia, and North America. They stood out for their size, fur, and large tusks. They were between 3 or 3.5 meters tall and weighed between 6 or 8 tons. The last woolly mammoths lived on Wrangel Island in the Bering Sea until about 4,000 years ago. So they were probably still alive when the Cycladic civilization was flourishing and when the pyramids of Egypt were being built. Could scientists bring this extinct species back to life? Scientists aren't exactly trying to clone mammoths. The situation is a bit more complicated. Although genetic material has been recovered from woolly mammoths buried in the ice, the DNA molecules are quite worn and the genetic material is now very fragile. The scrapped strands of DNA can hardly be cloned, but their sequences can be read. Instead of cloning mammoths with their own almost dissolved DNA, scientists are trying to create a mammoth using the same recipe using their closest living relative, the Asian elephant. They will endow them with greater fat mass, smaller ears, and thicker fur. If these modifications succeed, it will look just like a mammoth. In reality, however, it will be a modified elephant. Ethical dilemmas. There are many ethical dilemmas as to whether such a venture should proceed, with each side advocating its position. The scientific community that supports the idea says that this would help the ecosystem to slow down the greenhouse effect due to the important position that mammoths had in the Arctic regions, while those who disagree believe that man should not make such interventions in nature and that environmental arguments are misguided.